morning again, just starting early. Find the link and enjoy. For now, let's enjoy the music. Wait a little bit. Hope you're having a great day wherever you are. Good morning, I see people joining us already. Get ready, Anansi and the moss-covered rock. All right, good morning, Langston. Good morning, Tyler. Good morning, Steve. Hope you're doing well today. Again, today we're just starting a little early so people can get settled. Good morning, Nicole and Adrian. How are you doing? Are you still in Lisbon? Somebody is asking. Good morning, Lido Petroni. How are you doing today? Ingrid, Anders, how are you doing today? Great to see so many people coming on already. Awesome. Just enjoy the music for now and then we'll be getting started very soon. Good morning to you, Steve Wilson. Thank you so much. Good morning, Isabella. Good morning, Leslie. Good morning, Luis. Good morning, Danny. Good morning to you, Lydia. Thank you, Steve. Thank you. Much appreciated. Thank you, Danny. Yeah, wherever you're joining us from today, please, you are very welcome. Invite your neighbors, invite your friends, invite everybody to join in so we can share in this story. Hi, Ingrid. Anders, you need to send me the latest engineering project you're working on. I need to see that Lego building that you've done right now. Let's get together. Luis, Leslie, and Isabella. And Leslie, I hope you're enjoying your book. Congratulations again. Leslie was our winner for the art challenge, and she has a brand new copy of The Day the Crayons Quit. Welcome, everybody. Good morning, Ellen in Chicago. How are you doing today? The Windy City. Actually, you know, like, I was looking at my pictures and I just saw that in April, 4 years ago, I was in Chicago and just Facebook popped that up. And I'm like, oh, yeah, it's it was a great memory to see. But yeah. Hopefully you're doing great. Olive oil, good morning to you, my dear. How are you doing today? Awesome. All right, hugs to everybody for me at home, all right? And just a quick reminder too, if you're a parent at Emerson Elementary and you're signed up to pick up a Chromebook or computer for your child, just remember that this is coming up this Thursday and Friday, so just be aware of that. Rocco and Clay, good morning. How are you doing today? I missed you too, but hopefully you're able to catch the recording, right? All right, Ellen. Well, hopefully we have sun out here. Hopefully the sun can come out a little bit. Anders, well, the challenge is set to you. Build one. Send me a picture. Good morning to you, Owen. How are you doing today? Hopefully you get to go outside after story time. It's bright and looks warm and nice. I've not been outside myself, so I'm going by what I see in the window. Don't take my word for it. Oh, yeah. Good morning, Vincent. Good morning, Maya. Oh, awesome. I'm glad you can see Inu. That's our story time mascot right now. And I'm glad that you have your dog puppet. That's amazing. Oh, and his name is Barney. Awesome. That's a beautiful name for a dog. Zayana Steele, good morning. How are you doing today? I'm glad you could join us. Yes, hope everybody is in good spirits, enjoying it, enjoying your time with family. All right. Well, it is that time. We'll give it to 2 minutes, but while we wait for others to be logging on, we're just going to quickly go into some of the announcements that we have today. So yeah, the big one that we have is today. Yesterday I wrongly said it was Justine's birthday, but Justine's birthday is actually today. Good morning, Maya and Raven. Justine's birthday is today. Happy birthday to you, Justine. Big shout out. Yeah, growing up, growing older. Come on to Emerson when you're in a few years, right? All right, and then today is April Fool's Day, as you might already know. And just a few fun facts about April Fool's Day is that a study actually in the 1950s found that in the UK and countries whose traditions are derived from the UK, the joking ceases at midday. And I remember growing up in Zambia, and at noon, we were looking at that clock and waiting at noon so nobody could prank you anymore. But before then, it was free for all. It was open, different pranks going around. Hopefully there's some good good fun pranking going around in the house, but not too crazy. And then in Odessa, Ukraine, April 1st is celebrated with a parade in the city center. There's different performances, music, dance, comedy, all kinds of things, and people come out in costume. And this day is called Humorina, and it is a public holiday in the Ukraine. And Ukraine is the only country where that April Fool's is an observed holiday. So just something to know there. And then if you can notice from my t-shirt today, I'm wearing the Ride for a Reason t-shirt. This is one of, this is an annual ride, bike ride that happens here in Auckland, from Auckland to Sacramento. And it is to raise funds for public education and just raise awareness of all the needs that public education faces. So if you're in Auckland or if you're around that time, please think of participating in next year's ride. This year's ride was postponed, of course, because of the current situation, but if you can, please join in. It is a lot of fun. And there are three different levels that people can join in. You can join in at the 100 mile distance, you can join in at the 65, and then you can also join in at the 45. So everything. Some people I know have ridden for the last 10 miles of it, but the support, the camaraderie, everything is amazing. So think about it, Ride for a Reason next year. All right, and then Auckland Public Library has a lot of resources, and please visit them. And wherever you're watching us from, think about visiting your library website. Wherever you are, whether you're in LA, Chicago, wherever you are, please visit your library website and see what they offer. There's lots of things, ebooks, movies, and so on, many things that you could access. So please. And then there's also e-signing up for cards. You don't have to go in, you can sign in from your computer. So something to think about. Public libraries are there to serve you. Support them and they will support you back. And if you're an Emerson parent and are signed up for computer pickup, that is happening this Thursday and Friday. Please do go and pick up your child's computer so that they can access the online learning platforms that we will be using. All right, and then on an art piece, there's Mills College Children's School does art every night at 5 p.m. Pacific time with Miss Kitty. So follow at Miss Kitty 0912. Follow Miss Kitty at 0912 for art at 5 p.m. Pacific time. I've seen she was making what do the kids love? There's the gooey stuff. I'm forgetting the name right now. Slime. She made slime and it was amazing. I saw that, and so there's other things that she'll be doing. Join in today and see what she will be doing for the kids. And then don't forget the last one that we have. Fill out your census 2020. Today is census day 2020. Remember, every decade, every 10 years, you get to be counted. And so the government can make all the right choices in funding and everything else that goes with that. So please fill out your census 2020. Yes, Michelle, you always got my back. It is slime. Thank you so much. I love it. I love it. Michelle, Piedmont Ave, always got my back. Thank you so much. Yes, and Kathleen, Maya, and Raven say happy birthday to you, Justine. All right. Well, are you ready? Good morning. We have Josephina joining us as well. Good morning to everybody. All right. I am excited and ready to begin. Anansi and the moss-covered rock. Enjoy. This one is retold by Eric A. Kimmel and illustrated by Janet Stevens. The same that brought us the earlier installment that we read, Anansi and the Talking Melon. Good morning, Novalis and Taryn. Thank you for joining us. Thank you so much. All right, here we go. Anansi and the moss-covered rock. Once upon a time, Anansi the spider was walking through the forest when something caught his eye. It was a strange moss-covered rock. "How interesting," Anansi said. "Isn't this a strange moss-covered rock?" Kapum! Everything went black. And down fell Anansi, senseless. An hour later, Anansi woke up. His head was spinning. He wondered what had happened. "I was walking along the path when something caught my eye. I stopped and I said, 'Isn't this a strange moss-covered rock?'" Kapum! Down fell Anansi again. But this time, when he woke up an hour later, he knew exactly what was happening. "Aha," said Anansi. "This is a magic rock. And whenever anyone comes along and says the magic words, 'Isn't this a strange down he goes. "This is a good thing to know," said Anansi. "And I know just how to use it." It's April Fool's. Anansi is at work. So Anansi went walking through the forest until he came to Lion's house. Lion was sitting on his porch. At his feet was a great pile of yams. Anansi loved yams, but he was too lazy to dig them up himself. Anansi said to Lion, "Hello, Lion. It is very hot today. Don't you think so?" "Yes, Anansi," said Lion. "It is terribly hot. I am going for a walk in the cool forest," said Anansi. "Would you like to come?" "Oh, most certainly, Anansi, I would," said Lion. So Lion and Anansi went walking through the forest. After a while, Anansi led Lion to a certain place. "Lion, do you see what I see?" "Oh, yes, Anansi," said Lion. "Isn't this a strange moss-covered rock?" Kabam! Down fell Lion. Anansi ran back to Lion's house and made off with Lion's yams. An hour later, Lion woke up. His head was spinning. Anansi was nowhere in sight. And when he got home, he found that every single one of his yams was gone. Lion was very sad. But Anansi was very happy. He couldn't wait to play his trick again. Once more, Anansi went walking through the forest. This time, he stopped at Elephant's house. Elephant was sitting on his porch. At Elephant's feet was a great pile of bananas. Anansi loved bananas, but he was too lazy to pick them himself. So he said to Elephant, "Hello, Elephant. Isn't it hot today?" "I am going for a walk in the forest," Anansi said. "Would you like to come?" "That sounds nice, Anansi," said Elephant. "Thank you for inviting me." So Anansi and Elephant went walking through the forest. After a while, Anansi led Elephant to a certain place. "Elephant, look! Do you see what I see?" Elephant looked. "Oh yes, I do, Anansi. Isn't this a strange moss-covered rock?" Kapum! Down fell Elephant. Anansi ran back to Elephant's house and made off with all the bananas. An hour later, Elephant woke up. His head was spinning. Anansi was nowhere in sight. And when he got home, he found that every single one of his bananas was gone. Elephant was very sad. But Anansi was very happy. He couldn't wait to play his trick. He played it on rhinoceros and hippopotamus. He played it on giraffe and zebra. He played it on every single animal in the forest. But all this time, watching from behind the leaves, was little bush deer. Little bush deer is small and shy and very hard to see. She watched Anansi play his wicked trick again and again on the other animals. Little bush deer decided it was time for Anansi to learn a lesson. So little bush deer went deep into the forest to where the coconut trees grow. She climbed a coconut tree and threw down a great many coconuts. She carried the coconuts home in a basket and set them on her porch. Then she sat down beside them to wait. In a little while, along came, you guess who, Anansi. Anansi's eyes lit up when he saw little bush deer's coconuts. Anansi loved coconuts. He loved to eat the tender white coconut meat and drink the sweet coconut milk inside. But he was much too lazy to gather coconuts himself. Instead, he said, "Hello, bush deer. It is so hot today." Little bush deer smiled. "It is very hot, Anansi. I am going for a walk in the cool forest. Would you like to come?" "Yes, I would," said little bush deer. So Anansi and little bush deer went walking in the cool forest. After a while, Anansi led little bush deer to a certain place. Little bush deer knew all about Anansi's trick. Little bush deer, look, said Anansi. Do you see what I see? Little bush deer knew all about Anansi's trick. She looked. No, Anansi, I don't see anything. You must see it. Look carefully, Anansi said. Anansi began to get angry when bush deer said, no, I cannot see it. You must see it. Look over here. Look right here where I am pointing. Do you see it now? No, Anansi, said little bush deer. Anansi stamped his legs. Come on, you see it. You just don't want to say it. Say what? Little bush deer asked. You know, is that what I am supposed to say? Yes, said Anansi. All right then, I will say it to make you happy. You know, said little bush deer. There, I said it. Are you satisfied? No, Anansi shouted. You are not supposed to say you know. Well then, what am I supposed to say? You're supposed to say, isn't this a moss-covered rock? Kaboom! Down fell Anansi. Little bush deer ran and got all the other animals. Together they went to Anansi's house and took back all the good things he had stolen from them. An hour later, Anansi woke up. His head was spinning. Little bush deer was nowhere in sight. And when he got home, he found his house as empty as it was before. But if you think Anansi learned his lesson, you're mistaken. Because he is still playing tricks to this very day. The end. Well, kids, I hope you enjoyed that. I certainly did. And thank you for joining me on that adventure with Anansi the Trickster. Thank you. Thank you so much for joining in, everybody. And we will be back again tomorrow for another amazing story. And this time it will be Madeline Finn and the Library Dog. So join me for that one tomorrow. Let's just see who else has joined us from the last time I checked the comments. And we have Josephine came in. Dominique, you are very welcome. Naima, you're very welcome. I hope you enjoyed that story. Thank you so much. Michelle, thank you, thank you, thank you. All right. Oh, good, good. I'm glad people enjoyed that story. Anansi is definitely a character, and it was very appropriate that we honor him today on April Fool's. All right. So please remember again, we have Shravya joining us. Thank you so much. Please tell us who you're joining us with. Thank you. And then just remember too that today is Census Day, so please do not forget to submit your Census 2020. Stand up and be counted. And then Mills College, join Miss Kitty at 5 p.m. Pacific Time for art. Follow her at Miss Kitty 0912. On Instagram. And Oakland Public Library resources are available. Please sign in online. Emerson Computer Pickup is coming up on Thursday and Friday. Look out for the schedule on my page, on this Storytime with Mr. Limada page, and then also on Instagram. We will be posting that. And that's all that we had today. And a very big happy birthday once more to you, Justine. Happy, happy birthday. Thank you so much for joining me today. And I will see you again tomorrow when we join Madeline on her reading adventure. Thank you so much. Ada, bye-bye. See you again tomorrow.